You know, it's said every story has a hero, or at least one character that's main, but to call Larry anything less than grotesque is bordering on the insane. In a tavern booth in the days of my youth, we sat wasting away precious time. And one day what ensued, though, you may think it crude, is the plot for this story in rhyme. You see, Larry liked to bet. He yelled where he sat in a voice that was screechy and high. "Hey, barkeep! I will bet a $10 bill I can bite my own right eye." Now, this keep overgrown for being congenial weren't known, and his conversation often lacked grace, and all the hours therein that we'd spent in that den, we never once saw a smile on his face. He glared at our friend with an evil-like grin. I sure didn't think he'd bite, but he reached in the till, pulled out a bill, said, "I'd like to see you try it." Well, Larry popped out his glass eye, bit it not hard, then returned that thing to its socket. Then he picks up his win, and all the time widely grinning, stuck it in his pocket. Tender's face, it turned red. Some cuss words was said. It weren't hard seeing he wasn't too tickled. Larry saw the despise in them bloodshot eyes and grinned that grin he grins when he's pickled. "You're a strange sort of bloke. Most folks laugh at that joke, but you didn't," Larry said with a sigh. "But I'm a sporting man, so I'll bet one more ten I can bite my own left eye." "You couldn't be blind. I myself seen you find your way through tables and route to the John. You're trying to bluff. Think I've not guts enough? Well, I'm calling your hand, kid. You're on." Now, Larry weren't blind. That was easy to see. The keep thought he'd found his reprieve, so he laid down his tin spot, folded his arms. But Larry had a trick up his sleeve. You see, Larry'd been kicked in the mouth as a kid by this horse he'd been trying to bite. And what few teeth were left after that episode, some years later, got lost in a fight. This time, he didn't pop out any glass peeper, though he acted like he'd give it a try, but with the toothless grin of a man richer by 10, he used his false teeth to bite his left eye. Well, the bartender blew. He cussed Larry clean through. He said, "Take the money. Get out of this place. I've been swindled today. You've got most of my pay. You best leave while you still got a face."
"I assure you, sir, it was all done in jest. I didn't mean to make you upset. I'll give you a go to win back your dough if you just care to make one more bet. Now, if you'll go down far to the end of the bar and place their shot glass upright, I'll make a bet you won't regret, and most likely you'll be richer tonight. But I'll bet the 20 you had, then 10 more I'll add, that I can fill up that shot glass so far with nothing more than the juice from my lip full of snooze and not get one drop on your bar."
Well, the bartender knew it was at least 20 foot along that bar made inlaid hardwood, and although he known men who were good with their aim, no one was known to be that good. So he took up the bet and he laid down his dough. That shot glass was placed quick and neat. Larry steps up spry. "Let's tobacco juice fly." Not a drop came within 7 feet. Larry was beat. Revenge was sweet. The keep was laughing. "I knew it. The target was too far." He walked up with a grin, pocketed his win, grabbed a rag, and started cleaning that bar. "Hey, what's with your grin? You're now into me, Tin," he said, wiping the bar all the while.
"Well, I bet my friends where they are that I could spit on your bar and you'd wipe it up with a smile."